It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give it to you, I was on fire. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Energy Stadium here on the lakefront in Cleveland. It's the Buccaneers in possession of the football as we get back into it now in quarter number three. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. The last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me trying to get to the airport. The roads would be fairly clear by the time we have to leave the booth.
That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
There's certainly a lot of quality receivers on this team, so he's no lock to make this squad. But the way he's got to do it, make every routine catch that comes his way and mix in some of the big-time ones like the one we just saw there.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. From the shotgun, Griffin. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Complete in the end zone.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. And it's incomplete, almost intercepted. He had a great shot of picking that off in the end zone. It brings up fourth down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
38, Brown 7.
So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10.
Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
We'll see what they have up their sleeve. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
At the 32-yard line. A 2-yard pickup. brings up third and one.
Keenum going to throw on third and one. And that will be incomplete.
Keenum's pass.
The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
Back now comes Tampa Bay. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, try to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
They'll throw on first down with Griffin. And Blake, the tight end's got it.
Griffin's pass.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 19 yards there on the catch and run. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging into our second half blowout material. Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he's got this down to the 35. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Tyler Johnson ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game. And this offense is running away with this one.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. A four-play drive spanning 80 yards. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
It's a loss of a yard.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. He's going to air one out. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
At their own 20-yard line.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 41 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He'll wind up getting 11 on that one. And it's going to yield a new set of